We've almost finished with our flow, and we're now at the vital stage of verifying, testing, and refining our flow. Using test mode is a great way to test out your flow, as it allows you to just sync the newly created work items. For example, a few new test tasks. That way, we can identify any missing pieces with our flow. In this video, I'll be showing you how you can utilize test mode and make refinements to your flow before launching Unito to all your work items in your projects. Great, we're at the fifth and final step of our flow now, so we can go ahead and select continue here to launch our flow in test mode. Here we can name our flow. We recommend naming it in a way so it's easy to find in your list of flows. Your list of flows will be in alphabetical order, so you might want to prefix your flow with something so it shows in an order that makes sense. Here we can also choose to toggle auto sync on or off. If it's turned on, things will sync automatically in the background without you having to trigger anything. If you turn off auto sync, Unito will only sync changes when manually triggering a sync. The latter option may be useful during testing, but in most cases, you'll want auto sync turned on. Great, our flow is now processing the initial sync. Here we can see the flow status, which will tell us if the flow is currently processing a sync cycle, if the flow is healthy, if it needs to be reviewed, or if there's an issue that is preventing things from syncing. If we scroll down, we'll see the activity logs, which will show us the recent sync operations. Because we're in test mode, only new items will sync, so we'll need to go into our projects and create some new test tasks first. Let's have a play around and see how this looks. In this case, we're syncing Asana tasks into Jira one way. So I'm going to create a task in Asana first and add a bit of information to this test task to see how it looks over in Jira. Depending on your sync intervals, it will sync over in a few seconds, 5 minutes, or 15 minutes. If you don't want to wait for the next sync cycle, you can select sync now in your flow like I just did. This will then trigger a sync cycle immediately, and Unito will then go ahead and scan your projects for any new activity to sync over. Depending on how much new activity has happened since your last sync cycle, you may have to wait a little bit, so you might want to make a quick coffee and come back to check it out. As you can see, the Jira issue was created, so clicking the link will take us direct to the new Jira issue. From here, we can make sure all the necessary information has synced over from Asana into Jira. We recommend testing as many scenarios as possible. For example, creating tasks on both sides, updating fields, completing tasks, and so on. When running your tests, you may discover you made a mistake. Luckily, we're in test mode, so only these test tasks will be affected. If you need to make any refinements to your flow, you can easily edit your flow and apply those changes retroactively if you wish. In this example, we added a label to the Asana tasks, and we can see it didn't make it over to Jira. We can review our flow to see why this happened. There are no errors in the activity logs, so let's make sure we actually mapped this label. Configuring our labels over here, we can see that the label actually isn't mapped. So simply editing our flow, we can include this new label. When saving edits, you'll be given the option to apply this change on work items created or modified from this point forward, or you can apply the change retroactively to update all tasks already synced. In this case, I want to update the Jira issue that had already synced over to retroactively apply the label. So I would pick the option to apply this change to all historical tasks. Because I'm still in test mode, this change will only apply to my new test tasks. Note that if you pick this option and you've got a lot of tasks syncing, Unito will need some time to go through all of your tasks and update them with the new edits. In our activity stream, we can see a bit of update activity, which will tell us the labels were updated. Let's double check that in Jira to see how this looks. And there we go, as you can see, the Jira issue was updated with the correct label. Going back to our flow list, we'll be able to see our newly created flow. We can see here that it's still in test mode, and we can see the flow status from here as well. Once you're finished testing and you're happy, you can turn off test mode here in order to deploy your flow fully to all your historical tasks. In the next video, I'll be showing you what the process looks like when taking your flow out of test mode, as well as how to refine and grow your Unito setup as your workflow evolves.